deep in the forest of what is called the Emerald Triangle, the marijuana growing season
10 seconds.
Is about to begin.
There we go. Oh, I love this stuff.
Why was it so important to start moving the light back?
I wanted to fool these plants into a schedule and a cycle that says flower. I'm Mike Booten. My father was a police officer.
I love the smell of that right there.
My brother's a police officer. I was a jet engine mechanic on F-4 Phantoms in the Air Force. I've owned my own trucks, hauled logs, been an axe man. And now, I grow weed.
You know, we got a lot of plants to sink, so we'll go gather up Tawny and get busy.
It's June 1st. Mike and Tawny Booten are moving their plants from their indoor greenhouses out into the open. Over the next 5 months, an estimated $4.5 billion worth of marijuana will be grown and harvested in the Emerald Triangle.
I gotta tell you, Mr. Booten, these are some of the nicest plants.
Growers all throughout the area are staking their claim.
Tawny is my wife. She loves marijuana the same as I do. She's really the grower.
These are my babies. I love my girls. I get really heartbroken when something happens to them.
You missed a couple spots.
Growing marijuana is more than just sinking plants and keeping them watered.
Today's a big day, because today's like race day. What we do today determines what we're gonna get in quantity at the end of the year. And then, of course, everything that goes wrong just comes out of our wages. So you can't win the championship today, but you can lose it.
Growers like Booten can earn a year's salary in a single summer. With that kind of reward comes huge risk.
Planting marijuana outdoors in the full sun is putting a bullseye on your back. Some of these counties have it in their head that marijuana is illegal. That's all there is to it. Prove it to the judge. So one of the things that we're doing today by putting these plants in the ground, we're hoisting the flag of civil disobedience. It's going to be out there for the DEA to see. It's going to be out there for the Sheriff's Department to see. It's going to be out there for any marijuana thieves. All the forces that could take us down are at play every day from today on.
Over the next few days, Mike Booten will deliver 6 pounds of high-grade marijuana up and down the California coast.
Sack it. You have risks that range from law enforcement intervention. How much is legal to carry? Is it even legal to transport? Some jurisdictions will contend no. You get pulled over by one of those and you're going to jail. Am I an outlaw now because I'm at odds with state law, with federal law? I am an outlaw. I've always been an outlaw, but it doesn't mean I'm wrong. Yeah, I'll see you in a few days, okay?
Okay. Be careful.
Every time Booten goes on a run, he is leaving his home exposed to law enforcement raiding him or worse.
Things get weirder out here, you know? We just had a home invasion robbery day and the people got murdered, you know, in the process of it. So it's not like it couldn't happen here. I don't like the fact that it's just me and a dog here. You know, a bullet puts my dog down, and then where am I? You know, so it's scary. Come on, buddy.
This game is just like the wildebeest migration, you know. You gotta cross the river with the crocodiles in it, and, you know, I'm trying to catch the crocodiles asleep right now.
Not only does he have to avoid cops, Booten must dodge bandits looking to steal his cash or crop. Throughout the Emerald Triangle, they're known as rippers.
Rippers, they're just lazy. That's what they are. So you can't be too careful about being ambushed. People have been killed in this county over marijuana. Here comes a car, two of them.
Every set of headlights is a potential threat.
First one's nothing. Second one looked like it could have been law enforcement. That's what I don't like about this. It's uncertainty.
Thank you. A vehicle abruptly pulls out of the darkness.
I don't like the looks of that. I just picked up a van, man. I mean, I'm not really sure what this thing's all about. But, generally speaking, what you do to be a good neighbor on these roads is if you get somebody behind you, you pull over and let them by. I'm gonna attempt to do that, but if it looks like they're gonna pull in behind me, then I may have to come up with another plan, because I'm not gonna get jacked tonight. Looks like I'm looking for something as they go by. Here they go. I don't know who that was, but we don't take any chances out here in the middle of the night. All right, here we go. Oh, boy. Might have picked a bad night for a pot run. There's a motorcycle cop sitting right over there. See, he's just kind of radaring people from behind a bush. Very dangerous. Getting through the city in one piece, you know, without getting in an accident that causes police to come is the best way to ensure that I get the patients the medicine they need. I'm in a hurry, but not in such a big hurry that I want to get pulled over.
After 12 hours on the road, Mike Booten pulls up to a home in Redondo Beach. This is just one of many deliveries he'll be making in Southern California. But the guy who is about to receive Mike Booten's weed is not like other clients. He's a cop.
What's up? What up, Mikey? How are you?
Hey, man, your new place looks great.
Mike Booten has arrived at the final stop of a drug run that has taken him down the California coast.
I brought some really great Indo Royal.
Just like Booten's dad and brother, this guy is a cop.
I'm Nicholas. I'm former law enforcement. 15 years NYPD.
Nicholas is a former narcotics officer whose life was turned upside down.
I have this disease called avascular necrosis. What it does is it affects the artery that brings blood to the femoral head of your bone. I had a doctor of osteopathic medicine, and he said, Nick, man, he goes, in about a week or two, you're not gonna be able to walk. And I said, come on, man. And 2 weeks went by, and I had a cane. 2 weeks went by, and I was in a wheelchair. And 2 weeks went by, and I was crawling out of bed to get to the bathroom.
To ease his symptoms of his degenerative bone disease, Nicholas turned to cannabis.
Cannabis moves blood. And for someone with circulation problems, I had to move my blood quickly. And that's what I did.
Which he chooses to ingest rather than smoke.
Tastes good and clean.
Yeah, man.
Good deal.
If you smoke medical marijuana, you get 10 milligrams of the healthy medicine, where if you eat the cannabis, raw or dried, you get almost 600.
Not a lot of people would allow an ex-law enforcement officer into their collective, and I could understand that. It's unusual. But, you know, I'm comfortable with it because I come from a cop family.
Thank you, sir.
Sweet. He didn't come at me sideways. He came at me straight at me. I'm an ex-cop. No problem.
Hey, would you like some tea?
Yes. So basically, you're doing better.
I'm feeling good, man, you know? The weather, it's great. Everything's falling into place. The garden's keeping me busy.
And busy is good?
Busy is good.
One of the reasons I'll spend 12 hours in a car and dodge cops and grow marijuana and bring it to people like Nick is because, you know what? When I see that he can even walk up steps now, I'm gonna get down here and make sure he doesn't end up back in a wheelchair. Nick's a big part of the reason why we do what we do, and patients just like him. Cops be damned.